who's going to talk about supporting learning by considering emotions.
Good morning, everyone. My name is Samara, and I come from the University of the Basque Country. And I'm going to present my paper about tracking and visualizing students' emotions during classroom. And this work is a collaborative work between the KU Leuven in my stay there. So a good atmosphere and a positive learning environment in classroom motivate the students and leads them to a more effective learning, while negative emotions such as fear and stress can potentially disrupt learning. Besides influencing learning, the ability to regulate emotion is a proven predictor of academic outcomes. Students who can effectively regulate their emotions are stronger to overcome failure. So, in addition, emotions are gaining importance and visibility in our society, and they are being taken into account from different fields. As we can see, there is a TV series that study the microexpressions, the animation film winning the Oscar that has the main character, the principal emotions, and even Facebook added to the famous like the possibility to express different type of emotions. So we propose to register the emotions in classroom across the academic course in order to follow the emotional state of the students and help both teachers and students to discover problems on time and enrich the learning process. So knowing, for example, if students are bored or frustrated, anxious or even interested could help teachers to take steps during the course and adapt the teaching plan. Then our aim is to build a system that lets teachers and students track and visualize student emotions. In the same way as learning analytics application, what we want to do is involve the teacher in a process, and the student, sorry, in a process where we show data to them in order to make them aware of the problems that may be in the classroom, inducing them to question, think, and reflect to solve these problems in a sense-making steps with the final purpose to make an impact and change their behavior, if necessary, to a better classroom development. So our idea is to develop a quantifying emotion app that drives users across this process. And nowadays, we are really used to use this type of application. Who of you hasn't ever used an application of this type? We track the steps we walk, to the food we eat, our weight, or the physical activity. And even there are quantifying applications that already quantify the emotions, but they don't do it in a classroom environment. Regarding learning analytics application and quantifying application, we have developed the Presence Click system, a modular environment for teachers and students that quantify the interactions that happen in classroom day by day, such as the attendance or the students' answers to teachers' questions, the students' doubts, the exercise, or whatever interactions happen in real time. Even though emotions are not interactions by themselves, they can be one of the most influential factors in the way students interact. So the possibility to include emotion data will enrich the environment with valuable information. From this point, we arise the next research questions. Is it possible to adequately measure emotions that students feel in the classroom? How can students' emotions be visualized to promote self-reflection? And finally, what is the real impact of tracking and visualizing emotions on teaching learning context? So now I'm going to explain a little bit the methodology that we have followed in order to answer these research questions. First, we studied the principal models of emotions and different quantifying emotion apps in order to build a proper model of academic emotions. Then we built a questionnaire based on this model to quantify students' emotions through a self-report technique. In a second step, we made an exploratory analysis in the KU Leuven in an optional subject of visualization with 15 students where they track emotion and we saw it visualization And our objective here was to answer the first and the second research question about the quantification and the visualization. Then we create the emotion module in the presence click system. We tested it in two subjects in the University of the Basque Country with 97 students and with 81 students. And here our aim was to answer the questions about the visualization and about the impact in the learning. In addition, here we related the emotions to the final marks in the sum in order to build a prediction model of the student outcomes. We propose a model of emotions in an academic context that combines the model provided by Pekrun and colleagues and Arroyo and colleagues. Both works relate the detected emotions to the classroom environment. Thus, we obtain a model with 12 emotions, 6 positive, enjoyment, hope, pride, confidence, excitement, and interest, and 6 negative, anxiety, anger, shame, hopelessness, boredom, and frustration. In order to track students' emotions, we took as a sample the questionnaire provided by Pekrun, and we adapted it to all the emotions in the model. Here we can see an example for the emotion of frustration and interest. As our initial concern was to study the possibility of measuring emotions, we included 2 groups of items to learn about the students' emotions. Students were asked to what extent each emotions influenced their learning, that will be the influence items, and about the reliability when assessing their own emotions in class, that would be the confidence items. So the exploratory analysis lasted 6 weeks, as the course had only 1 session per week. In order to have enough data to analyze, we asked the student to do the question, to answer the questionnaire before class in order to think about the emotions that they had during the week previous to the session while they were working in the activities of the subject, and after class to think about of the emotions that they had during the session. The first 2 classes, besides the emotion items, before class, we asked it also to answer the questionnaire, the questions about the influence in items and the confidence items. The next 2 classes, we showed some partial results and some visualizations in order to motivate them and continue tracking. And the 5th week, we created another visualization, a little bit more complex because they were experts in visualizations, and we created 2 web prototypes for both visualizations that they were personal and they can access them whenever they wanted. The final class, after accessing the prototypes, we asked them to answer the satisfaction questionnaire, and the next week, we did some interviews with a student and the access log study. In this stage, we wanted to answer the question about quantification and visualization. This box plot represents the student's answer to the influence and confidence items. Blue box plots are related to the positive emotions and brown to the negative ones. Light colors represent the answers in the first class, and dark ones are for the second class. As we can see, the answer of the students are quite positive, and the average value, more or less, for all the items is 4 or even bigger. And it should be noted that for the second class, the answers, the students' opinion increase in their opinion of the influence that these emotions have in their learning. And in confidence, it happens more or less the same. And in the second class, the average value for the students is 4 or even bigger. So with these results, in addition, we found correlations between the influence items and the confidence items. So the more importance they gave to an emotion related to their learning, the more they believed that they could quantify it. Due to the significantly good results, we consider the proposed T-model as an adequate way to register the students' emotions. So we think that we answered positively to the first research question. These are the visualizations that we created to show students' emotions in order to favor reflection. The first one are some common graphs. The bubble chart represents the timeline evolution of each emotion during the course. The staked bars are the average value of each emotion in comparison to the group. And the box plot show the timeline evolution of each emotion in comparison to the group. The other visualization shows the balance between the positive emotions and the negative ones. The pink color is the positive, the purple the negative, and the more dark are the own students. So we can see also the evolutions through the course between the rest of the students, and they can see the evolution during the course. So these are the results of the students' answer to the satisfaction questionnaire. As we can see, they think that visualization were easy to understand, so we consider the usability of the system high, although they have some problems, for example, with the sticky bars, that they say that they were not a good visualization schema because the data were difficult to compare. So we took into account this opinion because many of the students say that in order to improve for the next phase. About awareness and reflection, the results were good also. So we think that this visualization are good to promote reflection between the students, but again, they show different opinions. For example, one student said that, I don't think it is useful for me. I cannot easily express my feelings on a piece of paper or on a numeric scale. And another one says that it is useful if you look at it a couple of weeks later. It is visual and maybe you can do something about it. So there are different opinions, but in general, we consider that these visualizations can be a good manner to promote reflection in students. So this is to answer the question about visualizations. In the next step, we adapted the questionnaire to the emotion module in presence clip. I forgot to say, but the questionnaire done in Leuven was by Google Docs, and now we use emoticons in order to make the process a bit funnier and motivate the students. Here, as the subjects had three sessions per week, we thought that it was too much for students to say it after each class which were their emotions. So we gave the teacher the possibility to create different emotion events when they think they could be significant for their class. They can create chronological events about one session, 1 week, or a period of time, and free events that they can relate it to whatever activity of the course or group work or whatever. The experiment involved two stages during two academic years. We tested it in two subjects, in modular and object-oriented programming with 50 attendees per class, more or less. We did three events, from different nature, one for a session, for a week, and a free event to test also the functionality of the system. And after these three events that lasted 1 month, we did a satisfaction questionnaire and the access study in order to answer the visualization and the impact questions. The next year, we did the same in the subject of basic programming with 60 attendees, more or less, per class. And the first event was to know the emotional state of the students during the first classes. And the next five was done in the laboratory classes across all the course in order to know the evolution of the students during practical sessions. And these are the participants in the events. The last one was low because of a server problem, not because of the students. And finally, after the experiment, we carried out again the satisfaction questionnaire, where 22% of the participants in the events answered. And here again, we wanted to answer the question about visualization and about the impact in their learning. These are the visualization that we use in the motion module. We transform the bubble chart to emoticons because we take into account that the bubble chart show the same information as the box plot page. So we create a page with information for one event and a page with information for all the events in general. We change also the stake it bar because students in Leuven says that they were not a good visualization, and we use a bar chart in order to show the comparison to the average comparison to the group. These are the results for the satisfaction questionnaire. As we can see, the average value are quite positive also, so we think that the usability again is quite good because the visualizations were easy to understand and they show interesting information, although they have some problems with the box plot page, so we think that maybe a good explanation before using the system could help to understand better the visualizations. And about reflection, students agree also that these visualizations help them to reflect on their emotions. So we consider that we can answer positively again to the second question about visualizations. And finally, about the impact question, we ask the students about if these visualizations helps them to be more positive. In the first subject, only 1/3 of students agree with that, while 66% of students think in BP that it helps them to be more positive. If it could have an impact in their behavior, it happened more or less the same. In the first subject, only 1/3 of students agree with that, while the satisfaction increased considerably in the second subject. And finally, if they continue registering in MOOC, only 50% of the students will do it, while in BP, 80% of students would like to continue registering. And maybe this could be due to the fact that they do across all the academic course and not only in a small period of time. So they can see the results of their tracking. In both subjects, we related the marks in the sum with the media of the positive and negative emotions, and we find correlations in MOOP with the positive emotions and the negative emotions. As more positive a student is, higher is the mark in the sum, and as more negative, lower the mark. In BP, we didn't find correlation, and taking all the data set all together, we find correlations with the negative emotions. So we think that maybe emotions can be a predictor of the student performance in this exam, so working this field maybe can help a lot the teacher in order to detect problems on time and avoid failure in the exam. So these are the research questions that we propose, and we think that the team model and the team questionnaire could be a good way to measure the students' emotions, and due to the significantly good results to the questions of influence in learning and confidence items, we think that it could be a good way to do it. According to the evaluation result of both phases, students' emotions can be displayed through several visualization techniques that involve them in self-reflection. So according to their opinion, we think also that we can say that students' emotions can be visualized with these visualizations. And finally, about the impact in the learning, taking all the experiment together, we found that 55% of the students thought that it has a positive impact in their learning. However, few students answered the satisfaction questionnaire in the emotion module. So we think that we need more experiment in this to answer these questions. And also, we have found that emotions can be a predictor for academic outcomes, so we are studying this issue also, including other interactions in presence clicks, such as the attendance of students. So, to finish with this presentation, I would like to say some words about Erik Duval. Most of you probably knew Erik, who, as you know, recently passed away. I just like to thank him for this work, who gave me the possibility to work with him and discover the interesting world of emotions and the beautiful person he was. All the things I learned from him will live forever, as well as his inspiring soul. So thank you, Erik, and thank you all for your attention.
Questions? Any questions?
Yeah. Hello, and thank you very much for this presentation. It's a very important topic, and it's very difficult to study. Oh, by the way, this is Xiao Hu from University of Hong Kong. I have a question regarding to your first research question. It is said to be emotion filled in the classroom, but as we know, we are having emotions all the time. So maybe the emotions you measure, maybe it's beyond the classroom. Maybe something happened in their life. Maybe they had a fight with their sisters before coming to the classroom. So how do you handle this kind of situation?
This is difficult to say. So we ask students to think about only in the classroom, but of course external problems can influence their answer. So. But I think that even these kind of problems, they can help to be aware of their own emotions, and they can deduce that, okay, it was because I had a problem outside class, so I have to concentrate in classroom. It's difficult to say.
Any other questions?
Economides from Greece. How do you think that when a student sees the emotions of the other students, how he will be affected? Not only how the student will be affected by seeing the emotions of the other students, and how his positive emotions and the negative emotions will be affected, as well as his or her performance in the test?
Well, I think that seeing the comparison to the group can situate the student in the group if he or she see that he's more positive in average to the group. It can motivate to follow and in the same line. And if the student is lower in the evolution to the group, maybe it can help them to be more aware and to motivate to improve in their learning, because he is being late in comparison to the group. I don't know if
But I'll follow up on that because, for example, someone who's experiencing a negative emotion is potentially going to get more negative upon seeing that. So there is a very real risk, I would have thought, in that sort of aggregation across the group. So have you thought about the implications of that at all? So the negative, someone who is experiencing a lot of negative emotions is likely to become more negative upon seeing that they're very negative compared to everyone else. So there's quite a feedback, and it could become a very negative feedback cycle you could enter into here. So have you thought about that, or have you seen any of those patterns of behavior?
Not sure. We haven't studied this issue, but I think that knowing if you are negative help you to try to improve, but it's true that maybe it's a circle that I don't know.
Garen Hiller from the Open University. I was just curious, if you were looking at the students that were having negative experiences, did you look for any relationships or interview any of them individually about? Did you look at any of the students that were having negative experiences to identify if they were related to irrelevant issues to the learning goal, or if the negative experience was associated with the learning goal that was at hand in the classroom?
We, as teachers, we don't know if a student in a specific student is negative because of privacy issues. So the teacher only can see the visualization of the group in general. So this tool is for be aware of own emotions. So the teacher can only see the emotional state of the group in general. So it cannot help a student in specific.
Thank you.
Anything else? Okay, so thank you.